Welcome to part two of the C-53 and Waco CG-4A story. And of course, that story started on January 31st, 1943, when a United States Army Air Force C-53 towing a Waco CG-4A from Van Nuys to Victorville Army Air Base got into severe turbulence north of the Van Nuys area and near the border of Ventura and LA County line in the mountains, and the tail of the C-53 was torn off the aircraft, resulting in fatalities for three of the C-53 crew and critical injuries for three others who managed to parachute to safety. The crew of the Waco glider landed safely with minor injuries. They parachuted out of their Waco, and they came down in rough country but got out okay. In January of 2012, Denise Robinson-Bartow and her mother, Anne, came out from the East Coast, not only to visit the crash site of the C-53, where their loved one miraculously survived, but also to visit the then 9-year-old girl, Marylynn Winkler, who helped to facilitate that survival. Marylynn was later thanked by General Hap Arnold, commander of the United States Army Air Force. She was called a heroine. She appeared on a radio program with Gene Autry, and she appeared in a comic book called Calling All Girls for her heroism. She walked 5.5 miles with her dad to reach the crash site. Marylynn's dad, Norman C. Winkler, then took two of the three parachutes to make an X on the ground to hopefully attract the attention of any aircraft flying in the area. He then told Marylynn that he was going to hike to the north to where the C-53 had crashed to see if there were any possible survivors. At this time, Marylynn was left doing the job of a nurse, really, taking care of the three badly injured men. She was only 9 years old, but she exhibited extraordinarily good judgment in her mission and her task that day. As she was tending to the men, an aircraft appeared overhead, circled several times, and then flew off to the south. That aircraft then notified, the pilot of that aircraft notified the authorities, and a search team was immediately launched. But because of the distance involved and the rugged terrain, they did not arrive at the crash site until late that evening. So it was key for the Robinson-Bartow family to meet Marylynn, and that was accomplished on this mission. And here we see a picture of Marylynn as she is today, holding a picture of Stewart Nengel. Stewart was so critically injured, it took him 3 months in a hospital and then an additional 3 months of rehabilitation before he could get back to any kind of normal state. He remained in the Army Air Force until the end of the war, leaving with the rank of sergeant. So again, a key person in this story is Marylynn Winkler, now Marylynn Winkler Butters, and she is shown here when we went out in late March to visit the C-53 crash site, holding a picture of Stewart Nengel. Stewart wrote her letters, she wrote him letters, they stayed in touch for a number of years after this event, and then they got in touch again with the family. So she knew that the family was coming out, that Stewart wouldn't be able to, and they had a great reunion at the crash site itself. So we see Marylynn at the crash site, and then Anne Robinson, and we see Denise Robinson-Bartow, and we see Francine Rippy, who is the property owner that was so gracious to let us go onto her ranch and to travel it extensively to get to the crash site. Some of the wreckage was right off the road we were traveling on, and that was just placed on the road for a brief memorial and then placed back into the chaparral afterwards. These reunions are always emotional, heartfelt, just amazing, an amazing day. In rough country, we had good weather, the mission was accomplished, The family was able to touch pieces of the wreckage. They were able to see the crash site. They were able to see where their loved one came down, where Stewart and the other two crewmen came down, where Marylynn found them and comforted them and helped them to survive this incredible ordeal. Every one of our Project Remembrance missions is contingent on teamwork, some good luck, and the cooperation in this case of a private property owner and the great cooperation of Marylynn Winkler, who said, come on down, bring him to my home. Let us gather. Let us go out to the crash site. Let's recount what happened that day.